no nii , tere päevast , Eesti pokrisõbrad , olen siin siis kõrvuti Jeff Soveriga , kes on Kanadast , elab praegult Poolas ja on selle turniiri chip leader ja küsime paar küsimust tema käest .
So you are from Canada actually, but you live in Poland, as I understand.
Yeah, that's right. But to make matters more complicated, I almost understood what you said because I understand a little Finnish. My mom's from Finland.
Okay.
So that complicates things.
Okay.
And I visited Estonia and I played there in a tournament in February, the European Masters of Poker.
Okay.
Nice little tournament.
Yeah.
And I got third, so it was nice.
Wow. So yeah. So you cashed in.
I cashed in. Yeah, it was a nice tournament.
Very good. And poker is your living or?
You know, let's say it's a hobby that takes up a lot of time.
Okay.
No, I have a business in Poland and that goes well, so I haven't quit my day job, but I come from a chess background. A lot of people know me through chess.
Okay.
I was a big chess monk. I was a chess player back in the day.
Uh-huh.
And I'm one of those people who moved over to poker.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And now you're a chip leader and your chip count is around one?
It's 232. I was up to 250, but I got chipped away in some bad situations.
So
but 230 is okay. Yeah.
So as Jeff is sitting in the same table with me, so he enjoys still these 250,000 chips while I'm going to take them away from him slowly.
He's gonna double up and double up again, probably.
Yeah,
that's what's going to happen, for sure.
What is your strategy has been here? You were chip leader already.
It's applying, choosing good spots and applying pressure in a way that makes sense at the right time.
Yeah.
And you could, so that means you could market off chips, like marketing, like, oh, I'm playing some weak hands now, or I'm vulnerable, and then you can hit back hard. There's different ways. You just have to feel different players, and you know, that's poker, right?
And you have even folded pretty big hands even with your big chip count.
I did fold some big hands because I didn't want to lose people. I can tell which people. Oh, well, I stacked a couple of people today who thought that they could fight back.
Yeah.
But right now the table doesn't really want to fight back for good reason. They have good cards usually.
Yeah,
I'm picking up. They might change their attitudes.
Do you remember this hand maybe for Estonian poker friends where you made this crazy call with Jack 8?
Yeah. It was a pair of eights. He was a Russian player and he was getting semi-short stacked. And it was a 60,000 pot or 70,000 pot. It was a very big at the beginning of the day. He made a small raise and I called with Jack 8. And then I flopped a pair of eights. It was like 8-9 and I forget what the other card was. But it was a blank. And he checked, I bet, and he made a mini raise.
Yes.
And this was a very strange time. So I had a talk with him for a long time. And then I called his mini raise because I knew he was going to push the turn.
Yeah.
But I was pretty sure he had ace-king, ace-queen, and I was right. He pushed on the turn, and I called with a pair of eights. And he had ace-queen, so
it was
a big bluff.
But good luck, Jeff.
Thank you.
And nice to see you again, maybe sometime in Estonia.
Okay, for sure.